what is the significance of hosting the Asia Pacific Ministerial Conference on Disaster Risk Reduction here in Manila in 2024? And can you tell us about the specific objectives that are associated with this event? Provide us insights into the preparations and collaborations involved in organizing, or maybe some expected outcomes from the event.
So let me say that first and foremost, we are very grateful that the government of Philippines has decided to host the Asia-Pacific Ministerial Conference for Disaster Risk Reduction. This is a regional conference for resilience for disaster risk reduction that is held in the region, and it is always a very important occasion. The last one was held in Brisbane, Australia, but the importance of next year's what we call APMCDRR, Asia-Pacific Ministerial Conference for Disaster Risk Reduction, in October is this, that it is the first one after the midterm review of the Sendai Framework has been concluded. There is a political declaration out there saying that, yes, we have advanced in some important issues such as understanding risk, but we are not achieving enough, and challenges are the list of challenges is longer than the list of achievements. So, and for example, there is this inequality, inclusivity issue. There is this issue of how can we localize disaster risk reduction more? How can the local governments become more engaged in it? And all of this will be discussed at the APMCDRR next year here in Manila. And it's crucially important because we only have 7 more years until 2030. If we cannot put our acts together, it will not happen that we build resilience. Asia Pacific is the most disaster prone region in the whole world. So what comes out of here, what comes out of from Manila in October next year will resonate not only within this region, but globally.
Yeah, so talking about the Philippines, can you tell us about your assessment of the Philippine DRR efforts, and do you see any areas for improvement?
So, I would say that it's excellent, and I'm not saying it because I'm being interviewed here in Manila, because there are so many important principles in disaster risk management that needs to be first and foremostly put. In the Philippines, of course, you know, there's a strong response and recovery program, but prevention has been put at the center of the policies, strategies for disaster. And this is not something normal. This is what we need to do because of the intensity and frequency of disasters, but prevention is not always something that the government focuses on. This is one thing. Second, in the Philippines, you have resilience at the top of the agenda at all levels, national, regional, local, and also at the community level. I just came out from a conference which is focusing on the resilience agenda at the barangay level. You know, these are the community leaders who really are at the forefront of response, but also they are at the forefront of prevention. Thirdly, there is a very, very strong public-private partnership in the Philippines. The Sendai Framework says that the implementation of the framework needs to be whole of society, and this means that this strong partnership needs to exist. Here in Philippines, you have it. And also, the partnership is supported with the academia, the science, and technology. And here I see a real whole of society attempt working. Early warning system. Philippines has a very advanced early warning system because it is so disaster prone. I can actually go on and on about it, but my point is, yes, you know, you have an excellent system, excellent structure, but of course, things can always get better. So we are in constant consultation mode with the government to see where can we, as a UN system, where can the UN Office for Disaster Risk Reduction support further the resilience of the Philippines